गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट प्रोपोर्शन, क्लियर? वी हैव टू लर्न अबाउट एशियो और एशियो, सो आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक इज प्रोपोर्शन। व्हाट इज प्रोपोर्शन? एन इक्वलिटी ऑफ टू रेशियोज इज नॉन एज प्रोपोर्शन, क्लियर? एन इक्वलिटी ऑफ टू रेशियोज इज नॉन एज प्रोपोर्शन। एग्जाम्पल, 4:6 इक्वल टू 6:9। इफ दे आर इक्वल रेशियोज देन दे आर इन प्रोपोर्शन, क्लियर? If they are equal ratio, they are in proportion. If they are not equal ratio, they are not in proportion, because an equality of ratios is known as proportion. Clear? 4:6 and 4:6, 6:9. We retain in the form of 4/6 and 6/9. 2×2=4. 2×3=6. 3×2=6. 3×3=9. 2/3 = 2/3. So they are in proportion. These terms are in proportion. You have noticed that in proportion there are four terms. There are four terms: A ratio B, proportion, C ratio D. Clear? A is known as the first term. B is known as second term. C is known as third term. And D is known as fourth term. Clear? A and D is known as extreme terms. A and D is known as extreme terms. A and D is known as extreme terms. And B and C is known as means term. B and C is known as known as means term. Clear? If the product of extreme is equal to product of means, so the terms are in proportion. Clear? If the product of extreme is equal to product of means, then these are in proportion. Notice that this is the important point of the proportion. Clear? If the product of extreme is equal to product of means, then the terms are in proportion. So the product of extreme is equal to product of means, then these terms are in proportion. Clear? If the product of extreme not equal to product of means, not in proportion. Clear? A into D is not equal to B into C, so terms are not in proportion. Clear? Let us an example to prove that these terms are in proportion or not. Clear? We have two examples. 4:6 product of extreme, these are extreme terms. 4:9 equal to product of means, 6:6. 36 equal to 36, any key? Product of extreme is equal to product of means. Clear? Then this term proves that the product of extreme is equal to product of means. So they are in proportion. Clear? We have second example. to prove that which terms are not in proportion. The product of extreme not equal to product of means. So they are not in proportion. Clear? Students, you have noticed that the product of extreme is not equal to product of means, so they are not in proportion. Clear? We have the next topic is continued proportion. We have next topic, continued proportion. Continued proportion. Clear, student? In continued proportion, there are three terms. One term is repeated. Clear? These terms are, let us an example, 4, 6 and 9 are in continued proportion. Focus on the board, sir. Continued proportion. So we write it in the proportion form 4:6, proportion 6:9. Clear, student? One term is repeated. So 6 is repeated. So 4:6:9 is in proportion. They are in continued proportion. Clear? Our next topic is speed. Speed equals to distance per unit time is known as speed. Clear? The very important topic, very important point in speed, you have to solve most of the question according to this formula. If kilometer per hour changes into meter per second, what we do? We know that 1 kilometer equal to 1000 meter, 1 hour equal to 3600 second. So 1 meter contain 1000 meter, 1 kilometer contain 1000. 2 5 10, 2 8 36, the terms are 5/18 meter per second. If kilometer per hour changes into meter per second, we have to multiply 5/18. Clear? One of the example is here. 72 kilometer per hour changes into meter per second. We have to multiply 5/18. 72 into 5/18 meter per second. Direct 18 for the 72, 5 for the 20 meter per second. Clear, students? The next topic, if meter per second is changed into kilometer per hour. If meter per second changes into kilometer per hour, 1 meter contain 1/1000 kilometer and 1 second contain 1/3600 second. Clear, students? So it's changed into kilometer per hour. So 1/1000 kilometer by 1/3600 second. It reverses 3600 by 1000 kilometer per hour. 00 cut, 2 18 ja 2 5 ja. We have to multiply 18/5 kilometer per hour. We have an example. 20 meter per second changes into kilometer per hour. So 20 into, we have to multiply 18/5, 5 for the, we get 72 kilometer per hour. Clear, students? The last topic of this chapter is unitary method. Unitary method is a topic in which we find out the value of one substance, one thing, one object. Unitary method is our next topic. So in unitary method we have to find the value of one object. So its name is unitary. Unitary means unit. Unit means one. Clear? As for example, the cost price of 6 bowls each Rs. 90. Find the cost price of 10 bowls. Solution: the cost price of 6 bowls each Rs. 90, the cost price of one bowl is equal to 90 by 6, we get 15. So the cost price of 10 such bowl each Rs 15 into 10, we get Rs 150. Clear? Students, we have to learn. The next chapter is our lines and segment, angles and lines. In next video we have learned about lines and angle. First of all line, then about angle, what are complementary, what are supplementary angles. So we meet in next video. Okay.